You know, we have this story of a young man in the Bible, you know, born in a very good, wonderful family. Before he was born, even an angel came and announced his arrival. I'm talking about Samson. But Samson, with all the oil, with all the grace, as a Nazarite that was blessing him, he started loving women in church, a Nazarite. But on the other hand, was into worldly things, loving women. And before you know it, immediately he started loving women. All the oil on his head, everything about him, all the grace, all the wonderful things, praying well, singing well, everything vanished. And the worst thing that can happen to any man is to die in the camp of your enemies with your enemies. If the person wants to die, let the person die outside the camp of his enemies. Don't allow any devil to rubbish your destiny as yours. I beg you. If you read Judges 13:25, the Bible said that the Spirit of God was resting upon him and moving him mightily. It will move him in down. It will take him to Esther. Moving around him everywhere, everywhere. Until just one small girl decided to lavish the whole oil. She soaked the whole oil. And then he lost his vision, lost his life, lost his identity, his personality. He's speaking good grammar. Everything. Certificates. Discipline. How to be disciplined? Discipline will help you so much. Discipline is the ability to have self-control, the ability to say no when you want to say no. If you can just allow me to summarize, ability to say no when you're supposed to say no. Some young people in the church today, their problem is that you cannot say no when you're supposed to say no. And people will be thinking that the glory is still there when the glory has departed. You already are an anchor. Then you are in the midst of the camp. It's only another God knows. But God sent me to come so that the light in you will not diminish. The devil will not remove your candle in the daytime. Because that is what he did to Samson. Before you knew it, a young man just died like that. Both spiritual death and physical death. That's why you have to be careful. Be disciplined. Very, very important. Very, very important. 2 Timothy 2 verse 4. No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life, that he might please the one who hath called him or enlisted. Not entangle yourself. Separate yourself. Be disciplined. Discipline with what you eat. Discipline with what you dress. Discipline with everything about you. Discipline with what you drink. Even when nobody sees you, discipline with the bottles inside the fridge. Port Harcourt. Number three, you have to be word oriented. Become a person of the Word of God. Let the Word of God, Colossians 3 says, let this Word dwell richly in you in all wisdom. Joshua 1 verse 8, this book of the law shall not depart out of the mouth, but you shall meditate therein. Learn to meditate therein day and night. You cannot go and reach out to these ones wordlessly. You cannot. All over the place, there is deficiency of the word. Deficiency of the word will lead to darkness. The thick side of the darkness. Deficiency of the word. So you need the word. Let it dwell. Psalm 119 verse 9 and 11. How we know shall a young man make his way pure? He said, by taking heed in accordance with your word. The word have I hidden in my heart. Am I not sin against you? So many young people today are jumping from one sin to the other. They are graduating from small one to the other because the word is not there. You have so many people on social media. You spend 4 hours on social media. When it has to do with the word, you are empty of the word. And you're still a young person. What are you doing with your life? As a young person in my father's house, some of you are still living with your father. I collected my Bible, finished Genesis to Revelation. My parents used to live in Abaco. I was born in Abaco. Genesis to Revelation, cover to cover. Not married, single. Just finished the university. Are we still here? Practicing in one chamber around Neverton then. When I finished, I started again the second time. And some of the ladies are still here, waiting for one bro to propose. You are battling with proposer. The other one proposed me the other time. And I was still praying about it. Before I knew it, he has gone to another sister. Allah! How is he here? One came and said, 18 brothers proposed me. I said, Nena, confusion! When 18 brothers are proposing, you have no business, you have no other job. That is confusion. Where will you start? Where will you start? Can you engage yourself in some more serious things? And some men in the house, can you begin to become world-oriented? Before you will say you are thinking about school fees, how to pay school fees for junior. Before we get to that point, can you begin to go page to page, chapter to chapter, become world-oriented? Some of you, you know, you are following all sorts of people, all men, great men and women of God on social media. You are not following the scriptures. You didn't know how they got there. Why not develop yourself? Apostle, is it not better to develop oneself? Sit down, discipline yourself, study the word, and you will get there.